CNN space and defense correspondent Kristin Fisher is live this morning at the Kennedy Space Center. So, Kristin, a lot of stop and start questions about whether this could be remedied, but now they've scrubbed it. Do we know the full scope of the issue here?
We don't know the full scope, and we're trying to figure out right now. I'm not trying to figure this out. About 91 NASA engineers are trying to figure out if this is a few day delay or if this is perhaps longer. We've got a backup launch attempt on Friday, a third attempt on Monday, if this is something that they can fix on the launch pad. But if it's not something that they can fix on the launch pad, then they're going to have to roll it all the way back to the vertical assembly building, which takes about 3 days. You're looking at a much longer delay there. So we are awaiting a press conference, likely later today at some point from NASA, to walk us through what exactly went wrong and how quickly they think that they can fix it. But let me just kind of walk you through what exactly we know happened. First, there was a lightning strike issue this morning, lightning getting too close to the pad. They were able to move past that storm. Then there was a hydrogen leak issue. They were able to fix that. Then there was what they thought was a crack in the middle of the main tank, or a line of frozen foam, essentially. They were able to clear that and continue with launch, but it was the fourth problem that we encountered this morning that proved to be the reason for the scrub today. And to explain exactly what the issue is, I'm going to show you this model. This is obviously not of the Artemis SLS rocket. This is of the space shuttle, but it really works here because the SLS rocket is kind of like a Frankenstein rocket in the sense that they just cobbled together all sorts of different parts from the space shuttle program, put it together to make the largest, most powerful rocket ever built. So this is the main core stage right here. And just imagine that the space shuttle is not on it. What they did all the way at the bottom of this main burnt orange core stage is where the rockets are. There's four rockets. They are called RS-25. Excuse me, there's four engines. They're called RS-25 engines. The same engines, those cylinders right down here at the bottom of the space shuttle, they were taken from the shuttle, put on the bottom of the main core stage on the SLS Artemis rocket. And it was one of those rockets' engines, RS-25 engine number 3, to be specific, that's causing problems today. And specifically, those engines need to be cooled to a very precise temperature in order for the rocket to lift off. And for whatever reason, NASA officials were not comfortable that that one rocket engine had hit the precise temperature that they needed for liftoff. So that's why we're here today, and that's why this first test flight has been scrubbed. Jim and Poppy, I think it's very important to point out that this is a test flight. NASA officials have been stressing this from day one. We knew that this could be a very likely outcome today. They've never gotten this far in the countdown. So we know that they're going to try again, hopefully on Friday or Monday, unless this is a very severe issue, and then it becomes a much bigger problem after that, Jim and Poppy.